Okay, so let's see. We will go with a club start here again. So as long as we don't have the meta figure guard, we will start with a club here. We got a Hodge. Assassin, couldn't have been Moonlight. Come on. Over a week now that we didn't hit a Moonlight Diana. Wanna bet that once we hit it, it's like a game where Moonlight is contested. Divine Wukong. Let's see, because this could be Quicksilver Hurricane if we test like Warwick, for example, without really a divine unit that can maybe carry us through the early game. Let's hope we get gold here. It might have been three majors here, actually. I'm not going for Wukong 3 star here. Is this stronger, yes or no? You can drop mana onto the Nami for faster CC. So the Divine proc on 2 Divine is basically doing nothing. But Divine was proc, he was just walking. So we can eco here. Altus 6 Elise. Okay. You're not winning this one, huh? Okay, no Ludens for us. This is our play for now. I don't even know what kind of items we could build, because I have no idea what direction we're going. I would have liked to get the magic resistance in the carousel. Because in case we go would be Warwick, we would need two of them. Okay, we should have probably built an Hodge onto the Kindred, right? So we at least have anything. Wukong was stuck way too long onto the Galio. Maybe we are ashy here. Watch last whisper Quicksilver. I need to pee, I'll be right back. So we're having belt open. It could be trap claw, maybe we are rebuilding to get something better. Two people trying to go cultist here. You would need a giant slayer. Actually, it's nonsense. There's going to be 2-6 Kaltos players, then we would have probably needed to wait here instead of slamming the last Whisper to get a Giant Slayer. We can't take it. We have no items for her. He also has two ashes here. How can we play six elder? Can't, right? Well, never mind, now we can play six elder. Who do we elder though? Okay, we can go 8 now. And put in Kindred for Hunter and Spirit. Yo. That Ezreal was gone fast, huh? Okay, so if you're having trouble in the early game, try watching the fights closely so you know how they move. Then you can get better at positioning. Then once you figure out how to position, keep in mind that in early game it's really important to scout for assassins, right? And then just play whatever you get. And you need to know like when you lose, why do you lose. It's probably the only thing where there's like not a lot of suggestions being made here. Remember who you faced, for example. Okay, yeah, then the problem is you should not force comps. Like, in TFT you should just play what you're getting. You only force comps to learn how they work, and what's their strength and what's their weakness. If I get good items and units to decide for a comp before 4.1, then I will just pick it and commit to it and build the items accordingly. If I don't get any good units before 4.1, I will just choose it based on the chosen I get on the rolldown. Like currently 4.1 is the most important stage, and if you're like rolling down, don't just buy like the units you need for like a comp you have in mind. Try to buy key units out of other comps, so in case you're hitting a chosen in this direction, you can pivot to faster. People are still looking for Jhin, so we can take it. The trap claw is good versus the Nami and versus the Nami and the Ari player. We're not placing it yet. We will need to see if we use it for a stun. So we want to stun the Ari, so we will use it after she casts. The trap claw won us this fight here for sure. So don't slam items if you don't know exactly how the next fight is going. So we could still be running 9 elders here, that's why I took the Lulu before. Three items. Okay, our items are not that great. Oh, you got good ones. And Elderwood's bad. Oh, holy shit. Nunu, my man. Yeah, let's put it on the Warwick for the heal here, because he's going to die. Oh, Jin, don't one hit that Ashe here. Goodbye. Oh, we got him. That, since there was a lot of AD damage, that's why I decided to put in Dazzler here. Come on. That's the proc was on him though. Yeah, we can go divine here before divine. Okay, I was rolling too much and didn't scout correctly. So what can we do versus this freestyle Riven? We can stun her with Trap Claw. And get like a Lee Sin. So let's see. Okay, we got the first stun. Okay, Okay. Got her with the trap claw, Shane. But we can't pull it off again, right? Because they are stuck now. I don't want the Nico, want to use the Nikos. Nunu, do it. Do it, Nunu. Yep, got it. Nunu 3-star, our Riven counter.